Hello, everybody. It's me, Shen. I got a lot of space in here to walk around and get amped. I'm joined by Cab remotely. Just imagine Cab's right, or no, other way around. Cab's right here. Cab, how are you doing, buddy?
Give you a pound. I'm doing quite well. Yeah, hopefully. Right. I wouldn't say hopefully the tournament's been doing well. It has been doing well. I've been watching a lot of the matches. It's been quite fun.
It's been crazy here. I have been sweating literally all day, Mr. Caboozled.
Understandable.
I am ready for a crazy match. We got Promo versus Puffy. Are you ready? I'm going to let them go. Well, let's just get going.
All right. So, Promo versus Puffy, which we know is coming soon. I find that an extremely interesting matchup for a number of reasons, actually. But I think... yes, I'm able to. I think part of what makes this matchup so interesting, though, is just, like, the dynamic of play styles here. Because the way Puffy plays is, like, really counter-spike-based. I would definitely know because I played a practice set against Puffy earlier today. And I think the way Promo plays is definitely offensively-based, especially because he's, like, a slower Tetris player, right? He, like, not slower Tetris player as in he plays slowly. Rather, like, he's more used to that, I'd say, back-to-back focus style that he used in the previous other games. Mm-hmm. And I think Puffy kind of showed that with that round right there. Just like the counter spiking can really get certain players off guard. So I think Promo's going to need to be careful of that if he wants to be able to stay on his feet during this match.
All right, I had to catch my breath for a moment. I just ran up some flights upstairs. But we're golden, and it looks like 1-1. So Puffy, I'm not as familiar with as a player. I didn't realize how strong he was. He did make it to the top 4 today, so definitely no slouch. And
oh my goodness, that multiplier. And Puffy taking the lead 2-1. And exactly as I said, the counter spiking just coming in huge. If I may point out, I do believe the cams are switched on the stream.
Oh, yeah, you're right. So you could either do that. Let's just switch the cams. Simple.
All right.
I did miss part of your conversation. But Puffy's good at return spiking. Is that what I'm getting?
Yeah, just judging off the sets that I've played against them and I've seen them play against other people, they're definitely very good at that.
Okay, cool.
Though with that said, Promo is playing way faster than I think they normally would play. I'm seeing like a lot of high 3, almost 4 PPS rounds from Promo.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Promo's crazy, man.
Yeah, for sure. And as I say that, they're both stalling. Not entirely sure why. Maybe just thinking things through. All right. Back into the action here.
Mm-hmm. So we got Puffy working through, has some, a clean garbage at the bottom. At the bottom is board, giving Promo a chance to return.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like Promo wants to get to that left well, might be able to spike there if he was able to get a little double combo here.
Interesting TST decision from Puffy there. They kind of blocked their garbage with that one. So yeah, they ultimately pay the price for the greed. And of course, Promo with this damage output, able to punish.
Puffy getting a pep talk there, getting a little shoulder shake. See if you can bring it, man. If Puffy wins this, it would be quite the upset.
It would be quite the upset, though honestly, I could totally see it happening. As I say that, Promo shuts me up real fast. An insane amount of pressure coming out of his board there.
Take some PC open up for Puffy. Oh, yeah. Wait, trying to get a blocker canceled there.
Oh, this is a good board state for Promo, though. This is a lot of damage. Puffy needs to be able to defend fast. Nice cancels from Puffy, though. And Promo, with a few miss drops, going to have to spend a little bit of time cleaning up. And he's still stuck. Not so sure about some of those placements there, but Promo just zooming away at almost 3.5 PPS here. And Puffy with the miss drops this time. That's going to do that round. So, 5-2 for Promo. I do feel as though a lot of this set has been more or less determined by miss drops, and I think that's kind of expected in a lot of Tetris games, but especially here. Like, I see the momentum tends to shift just almost entirely off of who's creating mistakes.
Okay, sorry. Had Discord up for a second. Okay, so 5-3, Promo's favor. Ooh, a little bit of a misdrop there for Promo, but not that bad. Oh, as long as he can get through his clean well, he should be okay. Yeah.
Very underrated part of Puffy's playstyle. It's definitely their opener, though. You'll notice they open with something that might look a little bit foreign to those of you who have not played against Puffy before. And that would be Sailboat, an opener that Puffy can tend to burst out at almost 4, almost 5 PPS sometimes, actually. And I think that could end up being a big game changer as well, because it means you can't afford to misdrop. So, I could see that being a big influencer on the result of this match as well.
Any idea on what Puffy's sprint time is? He seems to be 3+, pretty much most of the game. Or is his sprint more in his tactics?
Yeah, though honestly, I think regardless of whatever their sprint time may be, like in versus, they can burst really fast. And they're starting to even it up here, 4-5.
Wow.
So, promo while still with the lead, not with a significant one.
Yeah. Going into this, I did find promo to be the favorite. It's been a long day here, so there's a lot of IRL factors in play. Promo's been in like every finals, pretty much. And,
fair enough.
Yeah, we'll see if he's able to muster up some strength. Everyone is tired, but I think, Puffy's tying it up 5-5, and it is.
That was actually. Yeah, that was actually quite unfortunate for Promo there. I think they tried to get the O piece to the right, but on Tetra, you sometimes have to be a little bit careful with what pieces can top you out at the top of the board there. So, Promo definitely paid the price for that one.
Puffy
here with the burst speed, mentioned, 3.6 PPS on that round. My goodness.
You know, before this game started, both players said, "In my misery," because they're both tired. So maybe Promo's going for the intentional loss. What do you think?
Perhaps, I don't know. I'm not exactly at the venue, so I don't have the best idea of exactly how tired the players are. Though, I will say this. I think if Promo's able to win this match, or Puffy wins this match for that matter, I think both of them have a decent shot at winning some of the later matches as well. So I think something they both have in common is upset potential. Like, they both have the ability to burst really fast and put out a lot of damage when they need to.
I do think both of them could take a win off of Mumbo or Firestorm, depending on how they're feeling today. It's been a long day, and, you know, nerves are at play. There's a lot on the line, too. So Puffy's ahead 8-5, needs 2 points to close it out. We'll see if Promo can run it back a little bit here.
Yeah, I think, like, just this burst speed from Puffy is just stifling for Promo. Like, the sheer speed that they're going at is comparable to like some of the best players in the world, actually.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, they haven't really dropped below 3. I guess I think Promo is a little faster, but not too important. Not able to get.
And there you go. Yeah, Promo finally getting good access to the clean garbage, and I think that's another factor that is really, really, really important in Tetrio. So, it's a lot of things that kind of go into a win, but one of the more significant things is certainly garbage access.
Working our way through. I kind of like Puffy's board. Yeah, some key spins into that clean right well. That's going to be a lot of pressure on Promo's side, and this is match point. Promo is tournament point on the line. Puffy with an upset potential here. Maybe to different people might not be considered an upset, but I think Puffy is lesser known than Promo, and they are bringing it right now.
For sure.
Oh!
With that said, though, Puffy with a bit of an awkward stack, not going to be able to live that one. Promo still down by 2 points. So if they're going to be able to bring it to a deuce, they're still going to need 2 more in a row, which I'm not sure how feasible that is against Puffy's openers, but we'll see.
Puffy's open there was crazy. I don't even know what that was. You might know.
Yeah, exactly. It's the sailboat.
Oh, that
pretty interesting. Yeah, pretty interesting opener.
That was cool. Promo on his tournament point.
Oh, Christ, that was close. Barely able to downstack out of that, though, and Promo gets another lease on life here.
Oh, the pass through!
And there you go. Puffy with a huge upset there. Gonna take out Promo 10-7.
Wow.
I think loser semis, right?
That was the semifinals, and they're gonna play the loser of Wumbo and Firestorm coming up next. Are you ready, Cab? Are you pumped?
I will say, Wumbo versus Firestorm is quite a classic matchup, especially for those of you who used to watch the Jester's Cups, maybe like more than a year back. They definitely played a lot on that platform. And while Webbo hasn't been as active on Tetris until recently, I can see this being a very, very good match. This is going to be interesting.
Yeah, this is going to be sick, and I'm pretty excited. I'm going to round up the players. We're going to take a quick, take probably 3 minutes, 3 to 5 minutes, and we're going to hop into Wumbo versus, I almost said promo, Wumbo versus Firestorm. Let's go. We'll be right back.
All right.